Hello, everyone. This is the third short segment in a series of three that I'm calling Unusual Dough Bowls of the New Mexico Pueblo Indians in the 20th century. This one is very unusual. It comes out of an Arizona collection, carefully put together, very unique examples of dough bowls. Unlike the other dough bowls that we've seen in this short series of three, this one has very little sign of use or wear. In fact, I had to talk to several of my friends, Al Anthony of Adobe Gallery and another collector of mine. We spent quite a bit of time talking about and thinking of this dough bowl, which originally felt to us to be from Cochiti Pueblo, but my feeling is it's not. Looking at the base, the tan base with the ring of somewhat darker tan orange, I have a sense that this is a Tiwa piece, possibly from San Ildefonso and dating to perhaps the 1920s or 1930s. We don't think of too many potters from that period of time at San Ildefonso making larger dough bowls, and this design is so unique. What a little research has shown us, and which the owner of this dough bowl already knew, is this is a design common from abandoned pueblo called Sankawi, S-A-N-K-A-W-I. The surface of the pottery there was almost a little powdery feeling, and the designs with the swirling water-like designs, dots within parallel lines, very typical of the work there, but this is not an ancient piece of pottery. So what might an explanation be? In the 1920s and early 30s, Kenneth Chapman of the Laboratory of Anthropology, and before Kenneth Chapman, Edgar Hewitt, encouraged the potters to come to the Laboratory of Anthropology, the fledgling School of American Research, to copy old designs and to perpetuate the artistic movement forward of Pueblo pottery by the marrying of the modern with the old. So who was making bowls at San Ildefonso Pueblo, if I'm correct about that? Not many people I can think of except one, and that is the great Maria Martinez. Now, I'm suggesting that I'm not necessarily attributing the piece to Maria because I've just not known her to make this particular form in a bowl this large. If Maria designed it, chances are Julian painted it, yet the design work, the artistic feel of the piece doesn't feel like Julian, except there is a piece in the collection of SAR, the Old School of American Research, that looks a lot like this, and Julian may have been simply being true to the bowl and designing his design based on what he saw and trying to be true to the feel of it. I don't know if that's right, but I do know this. This is a beautiful dough bowl and very, very unusual, and in my experience, totally unique. I've never seen one like it.